All right, how's everyone doing? I am Rich Celenza. Thanks for checking out the Rich Celenza Show. So what I'm going to talk about today is it's not always easy to be healthy and wealthy at the same time. Now, if you know anything about me, a lot of times I do talk about, you know, taking care of your health should be your number one priority because obviously without it, you're nothing. But I do want people to understand, I know that a lot of people out there, you know, sometimes just don't have a lot of time to take care of their health. And, you know, especially if you're working 2-3 jobs, you got a family, you may be a, you know, a single parent. I don't know what it is, but I'm here to tell you when, you know, a lot of times when I talk about things, you know, I want the best for everyone. And, you know, I do want everyone to take care of their health to the best to their ability. I definitely don't want to make them feel bad that at certain times throughout their life, they may not be able to take care of themselves to the level that they want to. Because I do know a lot of people out there may not be able to afford to go to a gym or a fitness center or just do whatever they want to do as far as anything. It could be yoga, Pilates. It could be whatever they want to do. Maybe not being able to buy gym shoes to be a runner. I get it. You know, maybe not having enough money to buy certain types of foods at certain times. They have to eat a certain, or they have a certain budget, I should say, that they can't afford to do a lot of things. But in this podcast, what I kind of want to touch base upon is, you know, kind of throwing, not throwing anybody under the bus, but I see both sides a lot of times. And, you know, a lot of people I know that are pretty healthy, the thing that comes up a lot is when they talk about wealthy people, how come they don't, you know, take more time taking care of their health, right? Especially if they think they're making a lot of money and they're like, well, these people can hire, you know, chefs, you know, they can hire people to help them buy their groceries. They can hire a trainer. They can afford to do any type of workout. They could get the best of the clothes that they can, best trainers, if I didn't even mention that already. You know, all these things, there's no excuses for somebody who's wealthy not to be healthy. But I'm here to tell those people a lot of times, they don't understand what it is sometimes to be wealthy. Now, I'm not going to sit here and pretend like I was extremely wealthy by any means. But I do know what it is to have money to a certain degree and how much time and effort that that takes to become successful. And unless you're successful financially, you really don't know this. And here, I'm not here to throw anybody under the bus that is not wealthy. But what I am here to say is unless you walk in someone else's shoes, you know what I mean? You really don't know all the shit that you're stepping into. And when it comes to a lot of wealthy people, I know they do want to take care of their health. They want to be healthier. But a lot of them have a lot of responsibility and a lot work really hard. I'm not talking for many hours. You know, a lot of people talk about, oh, I work for 18 hours a day. I'm talking for decades. And one of the reasons they're successful is because they work hard. Not only that, they have a lot of responsibility. Like I said, they may own their own business or they may have worked themselves up, you know, in a corporate situation. They may have a lot of debt because they went to school. That could be a doctor, a lawyer. So they have expenses, right, that they had to work out and they've kind of programmed themselves to work really hard, get that money, pay off that debt. And I get it. I'm telling you right now, I understand where wealthy people a lot of times do not have time sometimes to, you know, really take care of their health to the level they should. They also have the responsibility maybe of families, you know, family members, friends that they may be helping, colleagues or, you know, employees, all these different types of things. You know what I mean? But I will say to people out there that are wealthy or doing really well, try to really, you know, understand though, what I try to teach people that are kind of, you know, I guess more upper class is after a certain amount of time of neglecting your health, you are going to pay a price one way or another. You can bullshit anything in life, but not your health. And a lot of money that you do end up making, you may end up spending trying to get your health back. I've talked about it could be surgeries, it could be anything. And, you know, sometimes you go too far and there's no coming back, especially if you've, say, smoked for a substantial amount of time or drank too much or became obese for too long of a period. And, you know, it is what it is. But I do think, I will say, no one actually should have a cop-out for not taking care of their health after a certain amount of time. Because if you are wealthy and you're doing really well, the same way you learned how to build wealth, you also need to kind of balance your time to also build your health. And, you know, a lot of people I get especially that are wealthy, are obsessed. They want to make 1 million, then 5 million, then 10 million, 20 million. It is a form of an addiction. And they don't want to take time out a lot of times to work on their health or really even think about it until a lot of times it's too late. So I also am going to say, I'm going to flip this now to, again, people that may be, you know, very healthy but not very wealthy. And I'm going to say to you, to a lot of people that out there always talk about rich people having all the benefits and why they shouldn't be neglected, or nothing should be neglected. Their health, they should have all these different perks being wealthy, and they should have, you know, all these things. But I'm here to tell you, I don't care if you're wealthy or not, no one goes unscathed. That goes for relationships, finances, deaths, illness. It all lines up. But I will say to people that aren't that wealthy, that are very healthy, who have spent a substantial amount of time, you know, staying in great shape and revolving a lot of, you know, of their life around their health, which is wonderful. But if they do kind of find themselves always struggling or not having a lot, one of the things you got to do is flip it. Because now you are telling wealthy people, you know, what they should do to keep healthy. Maybe you should learn how to become more wealthy, because you seem to have the health aspect down. But you probably should start learning how to maybe invest your money, save your money. And I'm going to be doing a podcast in the future about a lot of people I know that are healthy, which is wonderful. A lot of them are very obsessed with the way they look and appear, which is fine. But a lot of times what's going to happen is when you become so obsessed with yourself, with a lot of things, spending a lot of money only on yourself, again, not saving or investing or doing other things, that also may be destroying you. There's a fine line between both. The wealthy learning how to take care of themselves, their health, and not always being obsessed with, obviously, money. But also the healthy person not always being so obsessed with only health, which I get, you want to be healthy and want to live a long period of time. But if you're always struggling and you know, a lot of times you can't afford groceries or you're struggling to get rent, it's time for you to take a look and say, hey, what can I do now financially to better myself, right? Kind of flip it a little bit. Anyways, that's my two cents on this, but I definitely think people underestimate, you know, people on both sides, because I will say a lot of people that are wealthy, again, which I'll officially wrap it up with, will say to me, you know, these people that are all very healthy, Rich, you know, why don't they just take a class, or why don't they invest in something or learn about stocks or invest in real estate? It seems like all they want to do is work out, you know, cook meals, you know, do all these other things. I don't care if it's meditate, take these classes, run these marathons, or try to, you know, involve with maybe even like low-level bodybuilding stuff or shows. They get all obsessed with that for 6 months or a year, dieting, and then they're broke. Why don't they learn, you know what I mean, on the other end, how to make money, kind of like what I said earlier. So both have their kind of points of views that I've seen throughout my life. So just want to do a podcast on this just to kind of bring awareness to this a little bit and kind of bring a balance to it, at least from what I've seen. Got any questions or comments, please feel free to hit me up. I'm at richcelenza.com. Take care.